Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back to my channel, where you can learn the real-world coding experience, and this is Hong. Today's lesson is about coding for wood repairs, which is the most common procedures performed in the emergency department and throughout the US today. Having said that, it's very important that you got to know how to code these procedures, not only for your coding profession, but also for the coding exam as well. From my own experience and observation, question or case studies related to wound repairs are always on the coding exams, whether it's from a HEMA or AAPC. Alright, without further delay, let's get started. If you watched my last lesson about how to code burns, you would recognize this slide. It's about the basic anatomy and physiology of the skin. It would be very challenging for you to code any surgical procedures related to integumentary system without knowing the skin layers. The skin has three layers: the epidermis, the dermis, the hypodermis or subcutaneous tissue, and below this layer is the fascia or muscle. A superficial wound or laceration damages only the top two layers, the epidermis and the dermis, and possibly the subcutaneous, and usually requires just a simple one layer closer. On the other hand, a deeper wound or laceration will penetrate to the fat layer, to the muscle, so it usually requires more than one layer closer to approximate or close the deeper layers. That said, when you know the type of the wounds, superficial or deep, you would have an idea of how the physician is going to suture or close the wound, and this will help you to minimize the error that you could possibly make. This slide is about the three key elements. In order to accurately assign a code or codes for this type of procedure, you need to have these three key elements. First, the complexity of the repair or the layer involved. Either is simple, intermediate, or complex. Second, the location of the wound, and it is classified according to the anatomical location in CPT code description. Third is the length of the wound being repaired, measured in centimeter. If the wound measurement are documented in inches, then you have to convert it to the centimeter, just because CPT code use centimeter. This slide is about the complexity of the repair. First, simple repairs are for superficial wounds that involve the epidermis, dermis, or possible the subcutaneous tissue layer. CPT code range from 12001 to 12021. Typically, the physician performs a simple repair or one layer suture. Next, the intermediate repair or layer closer are for deeper wounds that require a layer closer of one or more of the deeper layers of subcutaneous tissue and superficial fascia. Most of the times are two layers. CPT code range from 12031 to 12057. Now, if you want to pass the coding exam, you must know this CPT manual guidelines. A single layer closer of heavily contaminated wounds requiring extensive cleaning or the removal of particulate matter also falls under intermediate repair. So please keep this in mind. Lastly, the complex repair are for deeper or more extensive wounds. For example, traumatic laceration or avulsion that requires more than a layer closer, such as debridement, extensive undermining, scar revision, or retention suture. CBD core range between 13100 to 13160. This slide is about the coating step you should follow in order to coat laceration or wound repair correctly. Step 1. Identify the repair complexity, whether it is simple repair, just one layer closer, or intermediate repair, two layers closer or more, or complex repair for traumatic or extensive wounds. Step 2. Identify the body side being repaired. You need to get a piece of paper. When multiple wounds are repaired, you jot down each side individually and then group them by the repair classification. Simples go with simple, intermediate go with intermediate, and complex will go with complex. Step 3. Identify the wound length and make sure it is measured in centimeter. When multiple wounds are repaired, you can add together the length in the same classification and form the same anatomical sign defined in CBD code descriptor. For example, CBD 12001, simple repair of scalp, next, axilla, trunk, extremity. Basically, you can add a simple repair of scalp and a simple repair of neck, and a simple repair of axilla, and a simple repair of trunk, and a simple repair of extremities all together. And make sure it must be documented in centimeter. If the wound measures in inches, then you need to convert it to centimeter. 1 inch equal to 2.54 centimeter. The good news is that on any coating exam, the wound will be documented in centimeter, so you don't need to convert it. This slide is about to highlight the base coat in your CBT book. In order to prepare for the coating exam, I want you to pause the video, get your CBT book, and highlight this base coat, and also tap this page because it's going to save you a lot of time. First of all, highlight this code 12001, simple repair of scalp, neck, axilla, external genitalia, trunk, extremity, 2.5 cm. Then highlight this code 12011, simple repair of face, ears, eyelids, nose, lips, less than 2.5 centimeter. Do you recognize the pattern? They are in the same repair classification. What is simple repair? But CBT code description group the anatomical side that you can add the length together. Next, these are the base code for the intermediate repair. 12031. Intermediate repair of scalp, axilla, trunk, extremities. Extremity means arms and legs. Less than 2.5 cm. 12041. Intermediate repair of neck, hands, feet, external genitalia. Less than 2.5 cm. And 12051. Intermediate repair of face, ears, eyelids, nose, lips, less than 2.5 centimeter. Again, do you see the pattern? They are all the same repair classification, which is intermediate repair. But the CBD code lists the sign that you can add in the same code. Lastly, please highlight the code 13100, complex repair trunk. 111 to 2.5 cm. 13120, complex repair, scalp and legs, 1.1 to 2.5 cm. 13131, complex repair, forehead, cheeks, chin, mouth, neck, axilla, genitalia, hands, feet, 1.1 to 2.5 centimeter. And lastly, 1-3-1-5-0, complex repair, eyelids, nose, ear, lips, less than 1.0 centimeter. Again, these are the basic that you need to highlight. For the coding exam, I want you to focus on the simple and intermediate repair only. All right, let's put it into practice. A 25 years old male was chopping wood with his friends and accidentally slashed his right lower leg with the axe. Upon assessment at the emergency room, it was determined that he had sliced through all layers of skin and the wound was down to the muscle, but no arteries were involved. He required layer closer suture, including the deeper layer of the subcutaneous tissue and superficial fascia, as well as the epidermis and dermis. His wounds were measured as approximately 25 centimeters. How would you call this procedure? For this purpose, I don't want you to call the external cause code, so just focus on the safety code for the procedure only. Now, remember the basic anatomy and physiology slide? When I talk about when you know the nature of the wound and how deep it is, you would have an idea how the doctor is going to suture this wound. And based on what you just read, this is a very deep wound. It has sliced to all layers of skin and the wound went down to the muscle. Okay, now follow the coding step. First of all, you have to identify the wound classification, whether or not it is a simple repair or intermediate repair. Here, his document, it requires layer suture closer, which means that intermediate repair. And then the next element is the side, which is the right lower leg. And the last element is the side of the wound, approximately 25 centimeters. So it's already documented in centimeters. After you have three key elements, you know this is a layer closer, which is intermediate repair. You go to the base code for intermediate repair, which is 1-2-0-3-1, intermediate repair, extremity 2.5 centimeter or less. Then from this code, you look under this code, you find the indented code for 25 centimeter. You would find CBT 1-2-0-3-6, intermediate repair, extremity 21.1 to 30 centimeter, and 25 centimeter is between this code range. So this is the right code. Let's do a complex case. A 10-year-old boy was running to his house and ran into a sliding glass door, breaking the glass and suffering severe laceration on his trunk and arms and minor laceration on his face and legs. The emergency department physician performed the simple closure of 1-2 centimeter laceration on the body cheeks and 2-2.3 centimeter laceration on the boy's left leg. The physician performed the simple closure of 1-4 centimeter laceration of the right arm and the layer closer up to laceration on the left arm, which were 1.5 and 3 centimeter respectively. The physician treated the 5 centimeter laceration on the boy's chest, which required the removal of particular glass and single layer closer. How would you call this procedure? For this learning purposes, you don't have to worry about the external cause code. Just focus on the safety code for this procedure only. Now, go back to this case. You see it's very complex because you are dealing with multiple wounds, multiple laceration on multiple body sides. So you need to follow the coding step in order to code this case correctly. First, You get a piece of paper, and then you write down one for simple repair column, and the other one for layer repair column. And then go back here. You're going to read. The emergency department physician performed the simple closure of 1-2 centimeter laceration on the body cheeks. So I'm going to list it down here. The cheeks, 2-0 centimeter. And then 2-2.3 centimeter laceration on the boy's left leg. I'm going to list it down here. 2 laceration. Each of them is 2.3 centimeter. The physician performed the simple closure of 1-4 centimeter laceration of the right arm. So still under simple repair. I will list it down here. The right arm 4 centimeter. Then, and the layer closure of 2 laceration on the left arm. Now, layer closure is considered intermediate repair. So you're going to list them down here. 2 laceration on the left arm, which were 1.5 and 3 centimeter. So I'm going to list it down here. Left arm 1.5 and the left arm 3 centimeter. The physician treated 5 centimeter laceration on the boy's chest, which required the removal of particular classes and a single layer closure. Remember, I told you about CBT coding guideline. Even though a single layer closure is performed, but because the physician had removed the particular class, it considered intermediate repair. That said, you're going to list the 5 centimeter laceration on the boy's chest under the layer repair. Now, after you have all the information, your job is to go to your CBT book, look under CBT base code, which I already asked you to highlight, and find the correct code for this. Now start with the base code 12011. Simple repair of face, ear, eyelids, nose, less than 2.5 centimeter. You would find cheeks is considered face and 2 centimeter. So it's the right code for this. CBT 12011. Now next, legs and arm are considered extremity. And it's under the same classification, simple repair. You can add them together. 2.3 plus 2.3 plus 4 is 8.6 centimeter. You look under the base code 12001, simple repair for extremity less than 2.5. Then you look under that to find the identical to match 8.6 centimeter. You would find this code. CBT 12004, simple repair of extremity 7.6 to 12.5 centimeter, and 8.6 is between this colon, so it's the right code. Next, you're going to deal with the layer repair or intermediate repair. Now, start with the base code 12031, intermediate repair of trunk and extremity less than 2.5 centimeter. Basically, CBT allows you to add the trunk, which is the chest here, and the extremity all together. So you can add 1.5 plus 3 plus 5 equal to 9.5 centimeter. So start from the base code 12031. You look under to find the identical for the 9.5 centimeter. You would find this code, CBT 12034, for the intermediate repair of trunk and extremity between 7.6 to 12.5 centimeter, and 9.5 is for between this code range, so it's correct code. Between these three codes, you list the more intense code first, which is 12034 first, and then these two codes right after that. I hope you get it. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for liking, sharing, and subscribing to my channel. Please don't forget to leave a comment or any suggestion below this video to let me know if it's helpful and easy to learn. I really appreciate it. Until next time, have a good day.